In SOLIDWORKS Electrical, you can connect an external database such as equipment stock management database to manufacturer part catalogs. This lets you retrieve data from your database and associate it with the electrical project components. In this video, we are going to associate this SQLite database to the existing manufacturer part library. We can associate up to 20 user data for cables and another 20 user data for parts. The sample database contains only the technical data for a single part. We can associate the ERP through the library tab, ERP connection database. In order to connect the database, we need to tick the option authorize connection and select database type, ADO access connection, SQS server connection, SQLite connection, ODBC data source connection. For the SQLite, we need just the database name, and if you have specific credentials, you must insert them too. The section main data is fundamental to map the database to make sure to assign the attributes to the right part. The reference number is an alphanumerical code. Most of the time is a unique cipher, but it might happen that two brands have the same reference number. Both parts should have the same part number but different attributes. To make sure to map the right part, we need two values. Ideally, these are the reference and the manufacturer. Furthermore, each user data should be associated to the right SQLite field. Before doing that, we assign a name to each user data and we sort them in groups. Now it's time to map the user data. Let's test the new SQLite database. As we can see, the part that we assigned to this push button has a dedicated ERP tab, and all the values are pulled through as expected. To show any of these properties on the scheme, it's necessary to modify the symbol and from the part user data section, add the right attribute. We can notice that the software created the folders stock and cost to match the user data groups previously edited in the ERP window. Adding any of these attributes, we can display their values next to the symbol. In the case the SQL database is edited, just the parts in the library will have this information updated. To update the parts already inserted into the project, we can use the command update data in the process tab. This tool shows all the parts that have some property discrepancies with the library and allows us to choose which part we want to update. In a few clicks, we can update all the project. If you want to show the new properties in the report, it's necessary to add a new column. Sometimes the user data that we want to show is not listed in the predefined query. It's our task to add it. Access to the expert mode section. Find the user data fields. Click edit and add them to the report query. The command test will show us a preview of the available properties. Finally, we can add the column and save the report. Every time you connect an ERP database, a file EWINI is generated on the server in an ERP folder. In this file are stored the connection settings, the field mapping, database location, username, and password. Open and modify it to change the settings.